The ingredients for life are spread throughout the universe. While Earth is the only known place in the universe with life, detecting life beyond Earth is a major goal of modern astronomy and planetary science. While these vital ingredients have often been observed in the cosmos, scientists have yet to find them all together at the same spot as they exist on Earth. That may all change, though, thanks to the James Webb Space Telescope. Latest reports suggest that the observatory has detected signs of life on several exoplanets. Let's take a closer look. For centuries, fictional depictions of planets orbiting other stars have fired our imagination. From the desert world of Arrakis and Dune to the lush jungles of Yoda's planet Dagobah in Star Wars, we humans have been fascinated with the idea of exotic, far-off worlds. We now know that worlds beyond our solar system, known as exoplanets, do exist. In fact, there are a whole lot of them. Scientists have found over 5,000 exoplanets and think that most stars have their own solar systems. Some exoplanets are surprisingly similar to fictional worlds we've imagined, while others have turned out to be more exotic than anything we could have dreamed. Our universe is estimated to have over 100 billion galaxies, each with hundreds of billions of stars. If most stars have one or more planets around them, there may be billions of trillions of planets in the universe. Every exoplanet discovery teaches us something new about how the universe works. When we just had our own solar system's 8 planets to study, we had a limited view of what kind of planetary systems are possible in the cosmos. Now, with over 5,000 exoplanets cataloged, the horizons of planetary science are broader than ever. We also sometimes get to see other solar systems forming, which teaches us about our own origins. It's like watching our very own How It's Made show through the world's telescopes. There are lots of reasons to learn about exoplanets, but perhaps the most compelling is that we could find another world that hosts living organisms. If we discover life beyond Earth, it could change the course of human history. And with continual advancements in exoplanet research, this discovery could happen in your lifetime. Even when looking through a powerful, ground or space-based telescope, stars look like tiny points of light. Planets are even tinier and are very difficult to spot next to their bright host stars. Therefore, scientists rely on indirect methods, like looking at the stars themselves, for signs that planets might be orbiting them. As these techniques have evolved, we've gone from merely being able to tell if a star has a planet to being able to detect characteristics of exoplanets. Through increasingly sophisticated technologies, we can not only figure out basic exoplanet traits like mass and diameter, but whether a world is solid or gaseous, or even has water vapor in the atmosphere. A new NASA mission called the Roman Space Telescope is an astrophysics and exoplanets mission that could launch as early as 2025 and will be able to detect Earth-sized rocky worlds. One of the main goals of exoplanet research is to find planets that resemble Earth. You'll often hear the term Earth-like used to describe worlds that resemble our own. Generally speaking, this means the planet might have liquid water and an atmosphere that could support life as we know it. Life on other worlds may be unrecognizably different from what we know here on Earth, and even life on our planet is extraordinarily diverse. But it makes sense to start by looking for worlds that resemble our own. The most basic condition for being able to sustain liquid water is the planet's position in relation to its star. Scientists call the region around a star where liquid water can exist on the surface of a planet the habitable zone. Not so close to the star that water all evaporates, and not so far from the star that it all freezes. This area is also known as the Goldilocks zone. We can tell if a planet is in a habitable zone based on the distance of the planet from its host star and the temperature of that star. A bigger, hotter star's habitable zone is farther out than that of a smaller, cooler star. There could be as many as 40 billion planets in the habitable zone of stars right here in our Milky Way galaxy. So far, we found about 20. That may not seem like many, but consider this. We may have already found a planet that hosts life, and we just don't know it yet. Imagine what our sun and Earth would look like from a few hundred light years away. Using our present-day technologies, you might be able to determine that Earth is a small, rocky planet that sits in the sun's habitable zone. Next, you could look for signs of water in the Earth's atmosphere to rule out that it wasn't a dry, desert planet like Mars. Our current technologies are just barely capable of doing this, while upcoming ground and space-based observatories will be able to do it even better. By then, you might be able to conclude that Earth was habitable. But to tell if there was life on the surface, you'd need to find gases in the planet's atmosphere like ozone that are possible byproducts of life. Our current and near-future telescopes won't be able to do this, but several proposed space telescopes might. Even then, you probably wouldn't be able to say for certain that you'd found life. Ultimately, it could take something like a telescope that uses our sun's gravity as a giant lens to capture a sharp picture of an exoplanet and see signs of life on the surface. This may sound impossibly futuristic, but the technology is not beyond our reach. Life might exist in the solar system where there is liquid water, like the subsurface aquifers on Mars, or in the oceans of Jupiter's moon Europa. However, searching for life in these places is incredibly difficult, as they are hard to reach, and detecting life would require sending a probe to return physical samples. Many astronomers believe there's a good chance that life exists on planets orbiting other stars, and that may be where life will be found first. To detect life on a distant planet, astrobiologists will study starlight that has interacted with the planet's surface or atmosphere. If the atmosphere or surface was transformed by life, the light may carry a clue, called a biosignature. For the first half of its existence, Earth sported atmosphere without oxygen, even though it hosted simple, single-celled life. Earth's biosignature was very faint during this early era. That changed abruptly 2.4 billion years ago when a new family of algae evolved. The algae used a process of photosynthesis that produces free oxygen, oxygen that isn't chemically bonded to any other element. From that time on, Earth's oxygen-filled atmosphere has left a strong and easily detectable biosignature on the light that passes through it. When light bounces off of the surface of a material or passes through a gas, certain wavelengths of this light are more likely to remain trapped in the gas or material surface than others. This selective trapping of wavelengths of light is why objects are different colors. Leaves are green because chlorophyll is particularly good at absorbing light in the red and blue wavelengths. As light hits a leaf, the red and blue wavelengths are absorbed, leaving mostly green light to bounce back into your eyes. The pattern of missing light is determined by the specific composition of the material the light interacts with. Because of this, astronomers can learn something about the composition of an exoplanet's atmosphere or surface by, in essence, measuring the specific color of light that comes from a planet. This method can be used to recognize the presence of certain atmospheric gases that are associated with life, such as oxygen or methane, because these gases leave very specific signatures in light. It also could be used to detect peculiar colors on the surface of a planet. On Earth, for example, the chlorophyll and other pigments plants and algae use for photosynthesis capture specific wavelengths of light. These pigments produce characteristic colors that can be detected by using a sensitive infrared camera. If you were to see this color reflecting off the surface of a distant planet, it would potentially signify the presence of chlorophyll. It takes an incredibly powerful telescope to detect these subtle changes to the light coming from a potentially habitable exoplanet. For now, the only telescope capable of such a feat is the new James Webb Space Telescope. As it began science operations in July 2022, James Webb took a reading of the spectrum of the gas giant exoplanet WASP-96b. The spectrum showed the presence of water in clouds, but a planet as large and hot as WASP-96b is unlikely to host life. However, this early data shows that James Webb is capable of detecting faint chemical signatures in the light coming from exoplanets. In the coming months, Webb is set to turn its mirrors towards TRAPPIST-1e, a potentially habitable Earth-sized planet a mere 39 light-years from Earth. Webb can look for biosignatures by studying planets as they pass in front of their host stars and capturing starlight that filters through the planet's atmosphere. But Webb was not designed to search for life, so the telescope is only able to scrutinize a few of the nearest potentially habitable worlds. It also can detect changes to atmospheric levels of carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor. While certain combinations of these gases may suggest life, Webb is not able to detect the presence of unbonded oxygen, which is the strongest signal for life. Leading concepts for future, even more powerful space telescopes include plans to block the bright light of a planet's host star to reveal starlight reflected from the planet. This idea is similar to using your hand to block sunlight to better see something in the distance. Future space telescopes could use small internal masks or large external umbrella-like spacecraft to do this. Once the starlight is blocked, it becomes much easier to study light bouncing off a planet. There are also three enormous ground-based telescopes currently under construction that will be able to search for biosignatures: the Giant Magellan Telescope, the 30-meter telescope, and the European Extremely Large Telescope. Each is far more powerful than existing telescopes on Earth, and despite the handicap of Earth's atmosphere distorting starlight, these telescopes might be able to probe the atmospheres of the closest worlds for oxygen. Even using the most powerful telescopes of the coming decades, astrobiologists will only be able to detect strong biosignatures produced by worlds that have been completely transformed by life. Unfortunately, most gases released by terrestrial life can also be produced by non-biological processes. Cows and volcanoes both release methane. Photosynthesis produces oxygen, but sunlight does too, when it splits water molecules into oxygen and hydrogen. There is a good chance astronomers will detect some false positives when looking for distant life. To help rule out false positives, astronomers will need to understand a planet of interest well enough to understand whether its geologic or atmospheric processes could mimic a biosignature. The next generation of exoplanet studies has the potential to pass the bar of the extraordinary evidence needed to prove the existence of life. The first data released from the James Webb Space Telescope gives us a sense of the exciting progress that's coming soon. If you like this video, please take a look at this one, which talks about the rotation of the Earth and why it has suddenly increased. Do you think there is life on TRAPPIST-1e? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.